You heard the term Latinx. It's a gender-neutral alternative to Latino or Latina. But the country's oldest Latino rights group says Latinx just isn't used enough in the Hispanic community. That's why LULAC tells our Melissa Correa it will not be using that term.
The U.S. has spent decades identifying the best term to better define a diverse population. Hispanic first made it onto a full census in 1980, but that word sparked resistance, so Latino was added to the census 20 years later. The Pew Research Center reports a surge in online searches for Latinx in 2016 after a shooting at Florida's Pulse, an LGBTQ nightclub that was hosting Latin Night when the massacre happened. Latinx is a gender-neutral alternative to Latino or Latina. Houstonian Austin Ruiz.
I use the term Latinx really because I see that as a very simple but a very meaningful way to see and to validate other people's existence other than my own.
Research shows while 1 in 4 U.S. Hispanics has heard of the term Latinx, only about 3% actually use it.
When I became national president 3 years ago, I set up an LGBT board position and we created several LGBT councils around the country. And they were more comfortable with the term Latinx. But what we saw was that it never caught on.
So Domingo Garcia, the president of LULAC, the country's oldest Latino rights group, decided this month the organization will stop using Latinx in messaging.
People didn't understand when you say Latinx. I mean, are we talking about dos X, una X? I don't know. It just didn't make sense. I think what we're seeing is what I call a pan-Latino movement.
Which is why LULAC suggests a person instead place their gender identity ahead of the word Hispanic or Latino.
So it's important that we get to know each other.
By opening up a conversation about how a person would like to be identified instead of assigning one single term to a diverse group of people. Melissa Correa, KHOU 11 News.